All along the Mississippi River, drought is dropping water levels to historic lows. And in Tennessee, it revealed this, an entire sunken boat. The riverboat named Diamond Lady was a floating casino in the 90s, but sat empty on the river for several years, eventually sinking during a storm last year. Up until recently, though, just the top deck was visible. Now, well, you can see what happens when the river is 11 feet below its historical average. Now, beyond the visuals, the river level may not seem like it impacts us a whole lot, but that's not quite true. It's having a big impact on bulk shipping. And tonight, Sharon explains the impacts that could have on our supply chain.
Just last month, Viking River Cruises blamed the low Mississippi levels for canceling a couple of its trips. But the depth of the river has far bigger implications than just on luxury cruises.
In the world of supply chain, there are things that are non-supply chain events that completely gum up the supply chain.
Fickle water levels on a river is definitely one of them, according to supply chain expert Pawan Joshi.
Anytime it goes up or goes down, it affects not just the loading unloading at the terminals. It also affects, you know, how much can be carried through.
While the Army Corps of Engineers has promised to dig deeper in some parts of the river identified as choke points, Joshi says that's not a fix-all.
You can continue to dig deeper and deeper, but if the water is only so much, you know, digging deep doesn't help.
So why do so many companies rely on something subject to the whims of Mother Nature?
Rivers are probably one of the most efficient modes of transportation. About a gallon load of fuel carries a ton of grain for about 500 miles if it's going on a barge. If that same one ton of grain that was moving on a truck will only go 60 miles.
Volume-wise, Joshi says a single barge can carry up to 50 to 60 truck trailers worth of bulk items.
If you think about it in terms of rail cars, it's about a 15 rail car load on a single barge. If you tie that back to a typical tugboat carrying anywhere between 15 to 30 barges, it's almost carrying the weight equivalent of two locomotives carrying two entire 100 rail car worth of stuff.
Plus, Joshi says opting for the roads rather than the river would only exacerbate the climate, not helping extreme weather cases like this drought.
It's in some ways climate change. Some of it is you know, cyclical in nature. But some of it is also the amount of carbon you're putting up in the atmosphere. If you start moving from a river-based system to a road-based system, you're not only needing more fuel, you're using more fuel for the same amount of distance, so you're pumping more carbon in back into the atmosphere.
One thing companies could do in the meantime?
You know, making sure that when you're driving one side, you're picking up grain, and when you're driving back, you're bringing stuff back in and not coming empty. That's effective utilization that needs to happen.
This goes without saying, but experts say that this is an issue that will continue to persist as this is something that doesn't have a simple solution. In St. Paul, Sharon Yu, Care 11 News.
Now, Joshi says he wishes companies that do utilize the river would talk to each other more, prioritizing perishable goods maybe before other bulk items that could afford to sit a while. But he says that's difficult without a single authority overseeing river barge traffic.